Hi, my name is Jacob McKay, and today I'm going to be discussing shots when videoing. Scahill always tells you five shots, five shots, five shots, and when meaning this, he's trying to help you make the best video possible. What he means by five shots is five different angles, five different settings, etc., etc. When filming, directors ensure that they get every angle possible, and to do this, they set up different cameras in different places and ensure that they can get every angle that. Then they can choose which one is best for their video. Today I'm going to show you just a few options that you can think about when you're filming, and of course there's many others to do, but let's get started. So first I have a panning shot. A panning shot is when the camera sort of rotates or moves side to side, and it reveals a setting to the audience and they get a sense of where the action is taking place or where the film is taking place. Next, I have a tracking shot. A tracking shot is when the camera is moving with the main focal point, main character, whatever you want to call it. And in this way, it helps get a sense that you're moving with the character as they're either running, you know, you see Nike commercials, they're running with the person. All right, now we have a tilt shot. A tilt shot is, it leans up towards the character, the object being looked at. These are usually used in sports and different TV shows I've seen them in. It's when they kind of look up at the character and make them look bigger, more masculine than they may or may not be. This is also used when characters are short in real life, but they want to be made larger in motion pictures.
This is an over-the-shoulder shot. These are typically used to get the focal point of the character being seen.
Like I said, these are just a few shots that you can take into account. Make sure you keep going to five shots, because the more shots you have, the better looking your video will be.
From your iPhone to iMovie. Open iPhoto and iMovie. Drag videos over to iMovie.
Hey guys. Alright, so this is the tutorial on how to use Final Cut Pro. Now the thing is, if you don't know how to use iMovie when you're coming into this, you probably don't want to try Final Cut because it's a lot more complex than iMovie is. I'm trying to show you this stupid tutorial on this camera in a dark room because we don't actually have anything that would make it so I can actually show you how to do it. So if this is like janky and bootlegged, then sorry. So for most people, you're going to find Final Cut in your applications. If it's not there and you want to try it out, ask someone like Scahill, because I know it wasn't on my computer to start, but he went and got it and put it on my computer. So for most people, it's going to be in your apps. I just have mine down here.
Yo, what's up? We're back again. The two dark brothers that are our friends. Hey, get in here. actually, I don't need you.
Alright, so once Final Cut boots up, any day now, I swear to God, Zach.
I'm not gonna do it.
Okay.
I'm filming a how-to film a how-to video.
Alright. I'm probably gonna cut this out anyways, because it takes forever. This camera's so annoying.
First, you wanna open up the video on your iPhone, then press record.
Okay. So once you're in Final Cut Pro, my mouse would work. What you have is, this is a project that's already done, but what you normally do is it starts up and you're gonna wanna hit new. So I'm just gonna create a new one here. You're gonna go to file, new, or not. There we go. Jesus. Give me a second. New project. There we go. Okay, so new project is gonna wipe your slate clean. So you have four windows. You have the bottom one, which is your timeline. You have the top three. You have your top three. And each one has a different function. So, for example, the upper left one has all your files in it. So, let me zoom in to show you. So, yeah. So, if you want new files added up there, you just go to File, and you find Import, and you hit Files. And then you'll just choose whatever you want in there. So, here, let me find something. So, I just imported something, and when you import it, you're gonna take it from this upper left box and drag it down into the bottom here and release it. And when you release it, it'll come up with a little red bar at the top of your timeline, which is the lower window. So what you're gonna do, what you're gonna do is you highlight it, or you just click on it, hit sequence, hit render selection. Oops. Normally you're gonna wanna save it before you render it. That was my mistake. And what it'll do is it'll load everything up so that it'll actually play on a screen. And so now you can play it through. And when you play your timeline, it'll appear in the upper right box over here. So that's what you see. And then if you want to find a specific clip and just play that clip, you can drag it actually into the middle box. And you can play that clip only in the middle box. But say you want to play everything you have on your project that you've edited so far. So let me find a music file and put it on so you guys can see what I'm talking about. Or not. There we go. So music goes below the double-spaced line on your timeline. Normally, so what you'll do is you'll import it, and you can drag it down. But then you're gonna have to render it again, but music takes less time than anything else to render. Okay, so now you see, if I go over here and click at the beginning of my video, it'll pop up over here. So this is the clip that I had. So you can play individual clips by dragging them into this middle box just to watch that. And then if you want to play everything you have, you'll go to the box on the right. So say you want to take out part of your video. There's this tiny little box over here. And there's a little thing that kind of looks like a card. I'll show you if I can. I don't know if it's gonna work. Right about here. So if you click on that card. Shit. So if you click on that card, you can drag your cursor around anywhere in your video and make cuts to it. And so when you make a cut, if you go and select the cursor on that same line, you can drag your cut clip around. And you can make, your cuts are specific, so wherever you want to make it, you have to make sure by scrolling through your video on the upper right box, you want to make the cut at a certain point. So that's basically the basics of Final Cut. That's pretty much all you need to know for just the beginning. So you're going to want to import your clips, which will go up here. If you want to view a specific clip, you can use that box. Your entire video goes up in this box. And then your timeline itself, which has all your clips, all your video, everything, and your music, will go down here on the bottom. And it's from there that you can play it, edit it, cut it by using the tools in this bar over here. All right, that's the basics to Final Cut. Remember, importing, you'll just go up to File and select Import and then Files. And then when you're all done with everything, here, hold on. When you're all done with everything, you'll go up into the corner, export, and you're gonna wanna hit QuickTime Movie, because that's what the computer that Scahill uses to put together everything. This is the format it needs to be in. If you use any of this other stuff, it won't necessarily work. So you need to export into QuickTime Movie, and you have to make sure your project is saved whenever you're doing anything, so you'll just save project. So you're gonna save it when you're done, export like that, and then when you export it, you should choose destination, so you can choose your desktop, and it'll come up as a movie file. Once you have that movie file, you can put it on a flash drive and you're all done. Alright guys, that was my Final Cut tutorial. If you have specific questions, you can come ask me or anyone else that knows how to use it, and I could probably help you out a little bit more. Remember, if you haven't done iMovie, this is probably not for you just because it's a little bit harder, but there's a lot more tools that you can use than iMovie. Alright guys, thanks.
So this is a how-to video on how to use your laptop to create videos. Step 1, cut on your computer and sign in. Step 2, once you are logged in, go to your bottom left and you'll see these four squares. Click on it. It will pop up to a screen like this. Step 3, you will be looking for a movie maker. So you're going to scroll all the way to the right until you see a desktop application, and the movie maker icon will look something like this. Click on it. And something like this should pop up. From this, there are three ways you could do this. The first way is you can add your videos and photos just by clicking here. If you don't have any of the clips on your laptop, then you could somehow get it from your phone. I will also show you that too. One way, you could get it off your phone if you have a Google account. The easiest way is to put your phone and sync it to your Google Photos account. Your Google Photos account saves everything from your photos and videos. So you can go to the internet, sign into your Gmail account, and there's this dotted dial pad box. You will click on that and scroll down till you see photos and click it. And from there, everything that you have will be up. To download, you tap on the video or photo, and there's like three dots in a line at the top right here. You click it, and three options should come up. Download, add to share album, and add to album. What you do, if you press download, it will download to your computer. See the pop-up at the bottom.
Click the pop-up that came up at the bottom of the screen with your video on it. And it should go automatic to your movie maker. Wait until it's downloading. When it's downloading, now you can edit. Editing is real simple. You go to the tab that says edit. Here, you can trim. You can split videos. You can set a starting point, ending point. You can control the speed. You can control the volume, make it fade in, fade out. You will be on this most of the time. Say if you want to put animation, you will go to your animation screen. So your animation screen shows you transitions and how long you want the transition to be. You can zoom, you can do anything. If you click on the home screen, you can add titles and captions, and you can record your voice. You can add music to your video. Your visual effects tab, click it. These effects is like the effects on a phone when you take pictures. You have different colors, different visions that you can use. let's go back to edit. When editing and you try to split it, what you have to do is press play, let it play for a while, and then pause it. You could play it by either pressing space bar or clicking down here. If you want to split, you can go to the top and it's an icon that says split. Tap it. Now the videos have split into two. You have one video, then you have the next. Say if you want to trim, you go to the trim tool, tap it. And down at the bottom right here, it gives you areas where you want to trim it. Say you want to start there and trim. And you put, say, trim. Look, you trimmed it. The other way is you could push a start button that's next to trim. You could start it, then click anywhere else, and you could press the end button to end it. And it cuts off all the other stuff that's after. To undo all this, there's an icon that looks like a backwards arrow next to the save icon up here on your left top screen. Just click that arrow, and you can go back as many times as you want to put back everything that you did. Now you can make your movie.
Start by finding your song, then copy the URL. They can imitate you, but they can't duplicate you, 'cause you got something special. In a new tab, search YouTube to MP3. I'm addicted like it's wrong. I want it all day long. Once you are there, paste the URL to convert to the video. Then click on convert video. Then click download. That makes me wanna taste you. It will then appear on your iTunes. Finally, drag it into iMovie. What you gonna do with that dessert?
All right, so today I'm going to be showing you guys how to download videos from YouTube, upload them to iTunes, and then from iTunes get those music on iMovie HD. Now, the first thing you're going to do is open up your browser, okay? So when you open up your browser, go straight to YouTube. Now, from YouTube, let's just pick your song in. So let's assume that you want to use Party in the USA for whatever reason. You're going to go to Party in the USA, type it in to the search bar or whatever, and then what you're going to do is you're going to click on the YouTube.
What you listening to?
The YouTube link. Okay, you're going to copy the link in the Finder bar. Okay, you're going to do copy, and then you're going to open a new tab. Now on the new tab, go to Google. And then once you're in Google, you're going to type in YouTube to MP3, okay? Now, from there, the first one that's going to come up is youtube-mp3.org. You're going to click on that website, and then in that website, on the first bar, there's going to be a link already in it. Now, delete that, and then go to Edit, Paste. Now, you do that, and you paste it into the bar, the link that you just copied from YouTube. Now, you're going to click Convert Video, and then once it converts successfully, you click Download. Now, as it downloads, it should pop up automatically to iTunes. Now, you don't have to listen to it. You can just exit that off. I forgot how terrible this song is. So, from there, you're going to go open up your iMovie or whatever it is you're editing on, and you can take that clip and drag it directly from iTunes into your iMovie, and you're going to drag it into that bar, and voila, you have a song, terrible song, granted, in your iMovie. Bye, I hate you and myself.
So the first thing you want to do is open your gallery and select the videos that you would like to share. Now you want to share them with your Google Drive so they will be accessible on any Google compatible device, but not the Macs. And you want to save it to your drive, obviously, yes. Okay. Now, exit out. And then you want to go to your Google Drive and you will want to select the videos that you desire for your video. You will then want to share these video clips with your Gmail account. You may have to send one or more emails depending on how big your video files are. Sending message. No. And you're done with your phone. Go to your Gmail account. Click the email you just sent yourself. Now I know my name. And download that video clip. Wait for the video clip to load. Drag it to your desktop. Are you seeing this? There it just is. Okay. Long out of that. You'll want to open whichever iMovie choice that you choose. I use iMovie HD. You drag the video file that you just did to the clips, the clipboard on the side of the clippy thingy. Wait for it to import. And add it to your video down at the bottom. And then, voila, you have your video.
Go to YouTube. Type in the name of the song. Click on the video, then highlight the URL and right click while pressing control. Copy the link, go to Google and type in YouTube to MP3. Click the first link that says YouTube to MP3 converter. A page will pop up. Delete the link in the box, right-click the mouse while holding control, and paste the link in the box. Then click convert video, then click download. The video will start to download as a song. The song will pop up in iTunes.
wondering why I'm here right now, I'm showing you, TV production, how to be an anchor. Now, obviously, the basics are read the teleprompter and do what you're supposed to be told. But you can be a great anchor if you do these three steps. Step number one is obviously smile when it's not your turn to talk.
Also, you want to kind of banter a little bit with your other anchor. Not too much or not too little. Just right, Goldilocks.
Step number three is you don't want to be too boring or too professional. You want to be a comedian. Like me or someone else. People don't think I'm funny. Wait, don't turn off. Wait, no, no.
I need to find a video that I need to make because I want to go to college. I need to do a commercial for the school.
You need to have an idea, okay? You need to have a good idea.
The second thing you're going to need to do is find people to record. Okay, because ideas are more than ideas. Don't let your dreams be dreams.
Yes. Pose for me, baby. Sexy, very sexy, very deep. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it.
Now, you got your idea. You got your people. But you need to edit, bro. Do you even edit? Now, you followed me through the journey of more success. Okay? You've got an idea. Bless up. You've recorded. Bless up. You edited. Bless up. But you need to import. Scahill needs to see it. They don't want you to import. Oh,
Hi, my name is David Gomez, and today I'm going to teach you how to do the three shots. Special shot, close up, long shot.
Close up.
Long shot!
Special shot.
first you log in.
Hey, do you want to come help?
Plug your flash drive in.
Oh, I'm going to talk to you. No, don't do it. What do you do after that?
Then you open whatever you want to export.
What are we exporting?
And then you hit export.
Absolutely yummy.
And then
you want to try some?
You hit full quality.
What is it?
Then share.
Sweet tea, pink lemonade.
And you.
Are you ready?
And then you.
First one I get out of pocket.
Share it to either Skayhill or whatever flash drive it is. And then you hit save. And then that's it.
Alright, so today I'm going to be showing you guys how to download videos from YouTube, upload them to iTunes, and then from iTunes get those music on iMovie HD. Now, the first thing you're going to need to do is open up your browser, okay? So when you open up your browser, go straight to YouTube. Now, from YouTube, let's just pick your song in. So let's assume that you want to use Party in the USA for whatever reason. You're going to go to Party in the USA, type it in to the search bar or whatever, and then what you're going to do is you're going to click on the YouTube.
What you listening to?
The YouTube link. Okay, you're going to copy the link in the Finder bar. Okay, you're going to do copy, and then you're going to open a new tab. Now on the new tab, go to Google. And then once you're in Google, you're going to type in YouTube to MP3, okay? Now, from there, the first one that's going to come up is youtube-mp3.org. You're going to click on that website, and then in that website, on the first bar, there's going to be a link already in it. Now, delete that, and then go to Edit, Paste. Now, you do that, and you paste it into the bar, the link that you just copied from YouTube. Now, you're going to click Convert Video, and then once it converts successfully, you click Download. Now, as it downloads, it should pop up automatically to iTunes. Now, you don't have to listen to it. You can just exit that off. I forgot how terrible this song is. So, from there, you're going to go open up your iMovie or whatever it is you're editing on, and you can take that clip and drag it directly from iTunes into your iMovie, and you're going to drag it into that bar, and voila, you have a song, terrible song, granted, in your iMovie by I Hate You and Myself.
The first thing you're going to want to do when b-rolling footage is to get rid of all other audio on the footage. So in order to do that, you can either extract the audio and delete it, which is a longer method, or you can highlight all of your footage that needs to be B-rolled. Go down to where it says clip volume right here. And highlight that. So it'll highlight that. It won't highlight. You just get rid of it and type in 0%. Press enter. Now when you go here, all of your footage should have be at the. The next step in B-rolling is to B-roll the footage and put your voice over it. What you're going to do is you're going to go down to this bar and click the middle button, media. When you do, all of this will pop up, everything involving media. All you're going to be concerned with is this little bar down here that says microphone. The little red dot next to it is the record button. When you scroll over it, it should say record audio. Now, when you click this, your footage will start to roll, and it will start to record your voice, like so. Everything I say right now is going over this footage exactly how it's said. The timing and everything is the same. Now, when you're done, you're going to go back over to here. You're going to click the same dots. Now it's the colors have flopped. What you're going to do is you're going to click it again, and it will stop foot rolling. Now that you've noticed that appeared, now let's take a look at how it turned out. Now we're going to see how it turned out. So what you're going to do is you're just going to press play, and let's listen.
Everything I say right now is going over this footage exactly how it said. The timing and everything is the same.
So it worked, and if we like the way that it sounds and timing, you've finished, you're done B-rolling. However, if you don't, just repeat the previous steps. Thank you, that is how you properly B-roll a footage.
Okay, so while exporting a video, first thing you're gonna do is hit File, go to Export. That'll drop down. You wanna put it to full quality there.
Full quality.
Make sure it's for full quality.
Full volume.
You're gonna press Share.
Share.
You're gonna name it with your name on it and whatever the video is.
Get the hell out of
here. So Scahill will know what it is.
Is Brett still in here?
Yeah, I'm coming back.
Yeah.
Is he still waiting on the flashlight?
Mm-hmm. And you go to Scale.
You go to Scale's thing.
And you press Save. And it compresses it.
And then that's how to export a video. Yo, you want to come and watch me do my how-to? Come on, watch this shit. Alright, so you're going to walk over here. You know, flick this nice little switch on. Alright, I'm doing mine. You're going to wait for it to... Ooh, damn, I look good.
Stop trying to do my video.
Hey, baby. I'm trying to do my video.
Move, I'll knock your ass out.
Hey, watch it. You don't do this in the classroom. Only random ass.
Alright, so you're going to click on your name.
Scahill.
And the Montagna. You're going to type your password in.
Hey, man.
And then you're going to log in. You're going to press Enter. That'd be that. I'm gonna wait for everything to load.
Hi.
You can click on iMovie. You gonna pull that little sucker up right there. Don't laugh at me. So you're gonna have all these nice little tabs where you can do things. You got themes, you have media. Media, you can do different types of stuff. Click on photos, look at photos. Then you got editing, you can edit stuff. Transitions, titles, video effects, audio effects. Then you got chapters. That's about it. You can just do it. Oh wow.
Hey guys, we're going to be doing a tutorial on how to fade in and fade out. So first, what you want to do is get your video clip in the little toolbar area. Then you want to drag it down to your timeline. Alright, So with this clip, we can see that it just immediately starts off, not like, you know, not a gradual fade in. And so what we want to do is go to editing, and then go to transitions, and then choose the fade in, and you drag it down to the beginning of your clip. Now, if we just watch it, nice fade in. The same goes if you want to do a fade out. Choose fade out option, drag it to the end, and there you go. A nice fade out. Thanks for watching.
Hi, I'm Caleb Hippensteel. I'm a 2016 senior, so I'm here to do a how-to video for you guys and help you guys pass this class, basically. And what I'm going to be teaching about individually is how to export a video. So after you've created this beautiful masterpiece that I'm sure you guys will be able to create based on the other how-to videos, I'm going to show you how to get that video and get it on Scahill's God-forbidden flash drive so you can actually get your 100% grade. So here we go. Okay, so first step, get the flash drive from Scahill. Usually it's in like a little bin in one of the rooms, but that might change by the time you're watching this video. So get the flash drive wherever it is from Scahill for your class. Okay, so next step, you got your flash drive. Next step, you're gonna be putting it into your keyboard so the computer can recognize it. And where you do that, there's a little itty bitty hole right here on the left side of your keyboard. And what you're gonna do, you're just gonna take it in and plug it in. Magical. The way you know that your flash drive is properly in the keyboard, you're going to see some sort of icon show up letting you know that it is indeed the USB that you just put in, okay? So now, your next step, after you've completed your amazing movie, as you can see mine is here, you're going to go to File, all the way down to Export right here. The screen will pop up, compress movie 4, and you're going to want to change this to full quality, okay? Then your next step is share. You can save this as whatever you want. This is what Scahill will see when he opens a flash drive. So you're probably going to want to put your name. My name's Caleb, in case you didn't know. And then where it says where, you're going to scroll down to the flash drive. And then all you got to do is hit save. And now the wait begins. 3, 2, 1. Oh man, I was too early. Oh well. But as you can see, it just finished. So now what you're gonna do is you're gonna make sure that it indeed did export. So what you gotta do, you gotta come over here to your flash drive icon on the computer. These videos will pop up that are on the flash drive, and make sure you find yours. I recommend even opening the flash drive and just simply taking a gander at it, watch it, make sure it's indeed what you want it to be so you can get your 100% grade, guys. I hope this video was really helpful, guys. I hope you have a great school year. You're gonna have a great time. This was always my favorite class in high school. Don't get on Scahill's bad side. Just have a good time, get your grades in, and it'll all be good. So have a great day. I hope the video helped.
how to download music. First, you're going to click on the Safari icon. Then you're going to type in YouTube. Then you type in the selection of your song. You're going to copy and paste it. And then drag it and put it on your desktop. So you're going to type in MP3 download. Click YouTube MP3 converter. And that's the website. Then you're going to delete what's in the URL section. Now you're going to drag your downloader into the URL section. Then you'll click convert. Now it's going to be downloading. Now you're going to press continue. Click download and let the song load. Last, you're going to click iTunes and then your song should be loaded right there. And that's how you download music.
There's many different types of shots, and not the shots you youngsters are thinking about. I'm talking about shots from TV production, and these vary from
close-up shots, medium shots, and long shots.
But the most special shot of them all would have to be special shots. You may be wondering what a special shot is. Well, what you just saw is one. A special shot can be a variation of a close-up shot, medium shot, and long shot according to the angle and the positioning of the camera. Just make it special.
Yo, what up guys, it's Byron. I'm going to teach you how to properly export your videos onto the flash drive for your DNN period. First you got to actually put the flash drive in. Then after that you're going to go to file. Go all the way down to export. It's like right there. And then you're gonna go ahead, after export pops up, it's gonna say compressing video, or this is where to compress video, how to compress video, whatever. And then you gotta go to full quality, change it to full quality. Then you're gonna go ahead, it's gonna pop up the name of the video. Then you put the name, whatever name, title the video, and make sure you put your name on it, because it's your video, and you can give you credit. And then after that,
can't feel anything. When will I learn? I push it down, push it down. I'm the one for a good time call. Phone's blowing up. Bring up my doorbell. I feel the love, feel the love.
Love.
drink, 1, 2, 3, drink. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, drink. Turn back till I ain't no scholar.
What's up? I'm gonna show you how to do some transition bullshit. Editing. You go up here, click that, type in some stuff. Boop, 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 boop. Choose a transition. Then you wanna go down here, click add. There it goes. There's your video. Done.
Alright guys, Seth here. So a little how-to video on how to use the standard Canon video cameras and scales for that. So let's go. So the first part of using this little green button right here. You push the button in and up to be able to video. See? And you push the same green button, but all the way down to view your video clips that you already filmed. And you just push it right back up. Turn it off. I like to, when I'm done filming, is to just push this little thing up to close your camera lens. You don't have to, but I do. So whenever your camera dies, you just want to plug it in right there in the bottom towards the battery. The last part is to get your tape out or put a new tape in. You just push this little button right here and pull out, and it opens itself up. You take your tape out, put a new one in, close it back, it goes down on its own. Yeah, and that's it, guys.
first step when adding music to a video is first you want to open the project. Next step is clicking on Media, and then iTunes if you've already downloaded your music into iTunes. Dragging the song into the middle bar. Next step, if you desire to cut the song, you want to go down to your keyboard and press Command T, and then delete. And then it's cut, and your audio is to your desired length. First, go to QuickTime Player, then click File, and click on New Screen Recording.
Oh, baby. 13, I have my first love. There was nobody that compared to my baby, and nobody came between us or could ever come above. She had me going crazy, oh, I was starstruck. She woke me up daily, don't need no Starbucks. She made my heart pound and skip a beat when I see her in the street and at school on the playground. But I really wanna see her on the weekend. She knows she got me dazing, cause she was so amazing. And now my heart is breaking, but I just keep on saying,
basics are read the teleprompter and do what you're supposed to be told. But you can be a great anchor if you do these three steps. Step number one is obviously smile when it's not your turn to talk. Also, you want to kind of banter a little bit with your other anchor. Not too much or not too little. Just right, Goldilocks. Step number three is you don't want to be too boring or too professional. You want to be a comedian, like me or someone else. People don't think I'm funny. Wait, don't turn off, wait, no, no.
I'm going to show you how to use this mini DVD player. First, you need to sign into your computer. Then, when you sign in, click on to add your movie, HD.
Oh, okay.
Then exit out of that. And create a new project. Doesn't matter what you name it. First, you need a camera and you need to open it to get the cassette out of the camera. Okay. close it back. And put the camera away. Then you turn on the DNN player. Then take the cassette player and put it the right way. Make sure this cord is connected to the back of the computer through the USB right there. And push it in. After you connect it, it should say that the camera is connected. Then you press play. And the video should start coming up. And once it comes up, press import in the middle of the screen.
Alright, so I'm gonna teach you guys how to adjust your sound volume on your clips and music. If you want to get your music into the video, click on media and then click on iTunes up in this upper box up here. And this should show all the files you have in your iTunes on your computer. And then you just take this, well, you take your file of choice, put in this bottom bar. And now that's in this bar, what you gotta do is click place that playhead to put it at the beginning or wherever your playhead is. And this line right here shows you the volume. You can put it up or down if you want it higher or lower, louder or, you know, softer. And you can also use this box right here and put in whatever number you want. That if you want a higher or lower, it doesn't matter. So yeah, that's really about it. And it's the same thing for clips. You can adjust it higher or lower if you want.
So today I'm going to be teaching you how to edit a video using iMovie HD. It's going to be the older version that is on your computer. You're going to go to the top button. Right here, you're going to click on the iMovie HD. You're going to click on Create New Project. You're going to name that project. I'm going to name it Tutorial Video. Okay, enter. Then you go to here. You're going to import your media, whatever it might be. There's other videos on that. Or you can take it and you can come here and you can just click and drag your piece to the project slide. Okay, now that we have our selected video, we are going to put it on the scissors, and we can either put it on the timeline. So this is already an edited video, but I'm going to edit anyways. So you can take it, and then where you get wherever you want to cut it, you pause and you hit Command T, and it's going to cut your different pieces into two different sizes. Okay. Close the door. It's okay. Sorry, people are walking in. Okay. Then you can take it. If you don't want this part right here, you can do another Command T to cut it. Then you click on only that piece, and you can either delete it, or you can move it up here so that you don't want to delete it, or you think that you're going to mess up or something like that. But there's always the edit toolbar that says undo move, and you can put it right back. So you're going to cut and move and delete anything that you don't need until your video looks good. You put music behind it by going to iTunes. You're going to download your music, your media. Then you can take it and you can click and drag to here. Make sure it's all the way in the front. Wait a second for it to upload. Now you have music behind it. Also, over here on the right, you can click these little arrow or these checks here, which allow each bar of sound to be played. So if I don't want the video sound to be played, I click that check mark off and the other sound check mark on. So now my music is on. You can pause, you can take the slider, you move it up and down on the sliding timeline. You click on the sound that is under your video. You can click that. And then, now it's cut into individual pieces just like your video is. So if you don't want this piece, you click on it, delete, move this forward. And now you play your video and you see how it, and if you want it to match up, you obviously match up the beats to the sound. So this is going to conclude my editing video. Thanks for watching.
Once you're ready to get music on video, you're going to click on Safari.
Now you got to go to YouTube. And now you're going to choose any song that you prefer for your video. Click it. And now you have to copy the link to the song. All right, now you're going to go to YouTube, or type in YouTube to MP3 in Google. And click the first one, YouTube MP3. Delete the link that's already there. And now paste the link that you copied from the YouTube video. Then click Convert Video. Now download the video. Cancel.
Click on the music icon by the trash can and drag the music into the timeline. And after that, you're going to drag it to where you want it to start. Once you have your music where you want it to start, you're going to go to the end and click on the audio and make sure you cut it at the end so the video doesn't keep going on. You probably want to fade out your music, so you're going to go to View and click on Show Video Clip Volume Levels. Click on the line and gradually decrease the volume level and it should be ready to go. And you can play it back to listen to it and make sure you just get it to where you want it. And if you follow these steps, you should be successful in getting music on your videos.
Thank you.
I am going to show you how to export videos much more efficiently. Instead of wasting everybody's time and rendering straight to the flash drive, which as you can see, takes a very long time, what you should do is render the video straight to your computer. Then get the flash drive, plug it in, and drag your video over to it, which takes significantly less time. As you can see, it takes 5 seconds compared to 10 minutes. That way, people do not have to wait 20 minutes to get the flash drive to export their videos.
Since you've seen videos on how to upload, you know how to do this already. So on this iMovie, which is that, you're gonna hit File, so File way up here, New Project, and whatever your project is, mine is commercial, but for this, I'm gonna put my name, hit Create. And once that's created, it's created a whole new project, see the ones I have here throughout the year. So once you've uploaded, the footage that you have filmed is gonna be here. You want to drag whatever part, so say I want it to start here. You're going to right click and drag this part. And see how, you know, you want to stop. Say I want the first 9 seconds. You're going to drag it up here. And that's it. And then to see what you've done, hit play, which is a space bar. You get to see it here. And to stop it, you just hit spacebar again. Now say you want another part, drag from over here, right click again, drag, say I want all of this. And you put it up here. Now if you want to cut something from up here, say the first, I don't know, 3 seconds or so, or 1 second, and then you're just gonna drag that part, hit delete. What that's gonna do is just delete it. Maybe something in the middle. You don't want that stuff. Hit delete. Now that's gonna cut it in two. Still smooth. Now if, say this guy, or whoever you filmed, isn't talking loud enough, or the class was too loud or something, you're gonna hit this little volume button. You're gonna hit it. What that's gonna do is bring up this, and say you want him to speak a little bit louder. This is at 100%. Say normally around 150, 170, that's gonna do it. And then normally you want automatic unless you wanna fool around with that, but then you're gonna hit done. And once you play it again, he's gonna seem a bit louder. So, and if you wanna keep messing around with that, just keep doing that. And this is cropping. So say you didn't want to get him, Alex. Say you didn't want to get Alex in it. So you just crop him right out of it. Say you didn't want to get his head, you just wanted to get his shirt. You're gonna drag it down. Maybe you wanted to flip it and you just hit that. Maybe you just want it upside down for some reason and you just drag it. But for this, I want it right side up and I want to get Alex out of it. Let's say I just want to get a shirt. Then you would hit done. And then it's just gonna zoom it in even more. So, and that'd be the same. If you wanted to mess around with colors of the video or the lightness, so say you wanted your white point as blue or green, and it would turn your whole video green. Saturation, the same, you can mess around with it. And same with the brightness, say if it's too dark, just lighten it up. And then you guys can just mess around with that and see how it is. And you just want to hit done so it saves it. And so that's how the video will play. Then again, you do have to do this for the entire thing unless you want it just to be that clip. And if you wanted to crop out even more, click to trim, which is that little like clock button. Hit it out. Say you wanted some more. Just go ahead and drag it out. Say you want the entire thing. And you're going to hit done. And see everything that you've done and see what that's gonna do is take whatever edits, see,
the green and the brightness, and it's gonna do it to the rest of it. So you could do it that way too. Remember, to play it all, you just hit the space bar. And you get to see it. And that's about it.
So, seeing as to how you guys are newbies, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to work on iMovie, the purple one,
I don't use the other ones at school, so we're gonna work with this one. I'm not gonna teach you all my tricks, but just the basics. One, you obviously had to have iMovie started, so I already have it, and I'm just gonna go to create a new movie. I have the Take On Me opening already open, so we're just gonna go ahead and start that. Now I'm going to start selecting the clips that I want to use. Depending on how many clips you have imported and you want to use into your video, it will take longer time. So once you have all the clips selected, we're just gonna drag them down. By the way that I did do all of them, I just pressed command and then I just clicked on all of them. So that's how you do it. So here I have all my clips and now I'm actually about to start arranging them in the order that I want. And now's the fun time for just cutting and editing all the videos. So you want to watch the whole video first and then go back to it and cut it. In this case, I'm doing that with this first clip. And he can just continue dancing. And so now we're going to go back, repeat, and so now I'm able to know where I am going to be cutting it. And I just added a transition. Whoops. To undo something, you have to do Command Z. In order to cut, you have to press Command B. To delete a small portion of the clip, all you have to do is just press Delete. Next thing is to just continue editing the videos to your liking. Then go ahead and start doing the same thing to your other videos. So what I just did was I shared the file onto my desktop. I just went to share and I exported it as a file. So now I'm actually going to do a cool background trick with the green screen. Firstly, you want to get a video that's going to be the green screen. In this case, I am going to be doing the Take On Me official music video. So I'm going to go ahead and drag that in first. And since I had already exported the Take On Me that I just edited, I'm going to drag it on top. While still on that first video that I just edited, I'm gonna go to the cutaway item option and I'm gonna change it from cutaway to green blue screen. This will allow me to see both the Take On Me actual video and the edited version of the lip sync that I'm doing. As you can probably tell on the sides, there are these black lines, sort of like those that you would see on a green screen. So we're actually gonna fix those right now. This time we're going to click on the actual Take On Me video opening and we're going to go to that little crop button and we're going to put crop to fill and just click a small portion of it and now it fills the whole screen. When you get to this last final part, you'll see that there's no more Take On Me music video. So now what we're just going to do is we're actually just going to press Command C. And then Command V, and now we have a second portion of that video. So basically what you just did was a copy and paste. In the end it will look something sort of like this. Obviously I have the audio taken out because I haven't worked on the audio yet. But as for green screen and editing the video, there you are.
Thank you.
doing a bunch of things, just gave him hints.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
I'm search YouTube.
No.
Just party videos.
What's going on, Mr. Skayhill?
I don't know. Oh, speed dial your mother, make up stories. I don't know.
You get it? Is it good?
Cut. Hey, Skayhill.
Yes.
I have a big, big favor to ask.
No. If it's about food, no.
Can I warm up my rice in your microwave?
No, that stuff stinks. That stuff stank.
I repeat myself. My video's gonna be better than you. I have
you know, fuck you, man.
You know the
I should hurt her, or else you're gonna owe me $10 every time you say that to her.
You subconsciously heard it. I love it.
No, I'm glad I know. All right.
These are really stupid.
After this,
having kind of a job.
What'd you change it to?
What?
What the?
Besides, what are you stealing? On Channel 9. Besides the you know, the crackers that you got picked up before. How did you miss that mouth? It's so big.
What was your?
You'll never have to shave your pit ever again. Your hair will stop growing now.
Skayhill, would you mess with a hairy girl? Come on.
Come on.
Would you? So is that it?
Can we define hair? Are we saying like 3 days after a shave, or are we saying like Amazon lady?
I'm saying Amazon lady.
Amazon?
Yeah.
Gavin, come on, you know about that. You're
So we can say that's a no now, right?
Skayhill, look at my dog.
Worse. I could have got beat.
That's a good thing I'm not trying to do.
That's a cute ass dog.
How cute my dog is. The little baby one?
Boxer.
The one that you just got? Gavin, you suck.
Okay. Your mom sucks me too.
Wow.
He's talking about.
Wasn't going there, but.
Wait, what kind of dog?
That is cute. That is cute.
What kind of dog is
that? I just thought I liked labs better.
Hey. No, look at her.
I have two labs.
She's cute though.
I have one.
He said, but and not the other way.
Not Gavin cute. You know.
I don't want to be cute as a dog.
Discipline. It's under the discipline video.
Does this have to be done today?
No, it has to be done by college weight. So okay. Probably next Thursday.
So I don't have to finish it by today.
No, there's no way. With the minute he showed me that list, I was like, ugh. I said, you don't want this today. Oh no, just by the end of next week. Okay.
Whoa!
Robert Edstrom.
How long has this been going on now?
Brendan
Bathlett. So Alex Buxton and Reed Wilson.
Hey, Alex.
And a domination. Goalie.
All guidelines we're trying to help will be explained, including physical paperwork, grades, workouts, and behavior expectations.
I don't know what to do.
Your name will be recorded for preliminary background checks. With...
Oh my god, I just put them back. Fuck you, Maddie!